You should rewind 2020. There isn't going to be one this year, so that's kind of awkward. They've been doing it for 10 years, and now they just finally decided to take a break for this time. A platform that is as big as YouTube is, that has millions and millions of hours of video on it, and thousands of these creators are top tier and really provide a lot of entertainment to you and I, well, they're letting us down this year. Now, if you somehow do not know what YouTube Rewind is, I find that hard to believe because you're watching this video, but it is kind of this reel of all of the events, the best moments, the trends, the biggest creators of the year. They always try and put a great story behind it, and I say try because there was one year very recently where nobody liked it. But basically, if you are a creator and you have affected an audience in some sort of way and you have skyrocketed in growth or awareness and YouTube knows about it, you're gonna be in YouTube Rewind. It's the YouTuber's rite of passage, basically. But if YouTube has been doing this for the past 10 years, why are they now deciding not to do it? Like, what is up, dude? A multi-billion dollar company is just deciding to not make one of the biggest produced videos of the year. And the reason why, well, at least they put it in this message for us on Twitter, well, they're telling us, you know, this year doesn't really feel like a really cheerful year, whereas the past years, they definitely were. There were these huge moments that we could go back and put in this big movie that we all like to enjoy and watch. But you know what, guys, this year, it just doesn't feel the same. 2020 has been different, and we don't want to treat it as if it wasn't different. We don't want to treat this year like it was some amazing year when it actually wasn't, is basically what they're saying. Now, what do they really mean by this? Well, if you are alive in 2020 and you are conscious and you are probably a functioning adult or teenager or child and you watch YouTube or you watch media in general, you probably know that a lot of shit has gone down this year, including, well, the COVID pandemic, the presidency that is giving us all a headache, probably, whether or not you are into politics. There has just been a lot of negativity this year, and negativity in the sort of aspect that affects all of us. Like, if you have a smartphone, you're paying attention to this. You have seen some sort of, well, if not the actual thing, then probably a meme of it. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, do you have that? YouTube, you're watching this on YouTube, you've probably seen something. That's what my best guess is, at least, is that this company of YouTube wants to keep their brand as safe as possible. And I mean, in the past, well, we can't blame them. They've gotten some pretty terrible ratings for just one little mess up in direction of the story of these videos. So I guess they're trying to play it safe and tell us all, like, yeah, guys, we have empathy for you. We totally know that you are part of what makes this year and YouTube great, because you, the creator, the creative, are the person that is making everything positive and uplifting in contrast to the negativity that we've all experienced this year. So no, we as YouTube are not saying that you suck. We are more so saying that this year sucked, and we don't want to act like this year has not sucked. Because if we don't act like this year has sucked and acknowledge that it has sucked, well, you might yell at us again and give us terrible ratings and probably riots at the company. Well, maybe not riot at the company per se, but if you're a company that has to keep a brand image, then you have to think about this kind of stuff. If we make this video while all of these other circumstances are on their way and have, well, made their way through the year, do we want to make this video that says, yeah, we're happy, this is all of the best moments of trends and YouTube and culture and video making and people on the internet? Like, do we really want to send that message to millions and millions of people that we know will watch this video because it is one of the most watched videos that we ever produce? Or would we rather kick back, just kind of watch how things are going, take empathy and sympathy, and just have gratitude for what we do have? I mean, you guys, think about this. If you were YouTube, what would you do? A lot of creators disagree with them, and that is a really apparent thing, and of course people might have that opinion. Big creators too, and even Mr. Beast was one of the creators that was recommended for directing the 2020 Rewind. So, well, that makes sense though. Mr. Beast is one of the top tier creators. He is a really great storyteller, and he is really good at just forcing positivity into the world like he does with everything that he pretty much produces ever. He is a really great storyteller, and he is really good at just forcing positivity into the world like he does. If you are a creator, or if you watch other YouTube creators, do you think that they might deserve a rewind anyways? Do you think that this year, although it has had its issues, how do you feel? Like, do you think that YouTube should still do the rewind, since it's like a traditional thing and they've done it for the past 10 years, and why break that trend now? Or do you think that they should just kick back like they're trying to do? I mean, if we take into consideration culture on social media, cancel culture for that matter, it's bad. Do you think that YouTube would have to deal with something like this if they ended up making a video that contrasts, well, how the year has quote-unquote sucked? Or do you think that they'd be fine? Fine line that they don't want to pass, I guess. Get it? They don't want to pass the fine line. Harry Styles. Sorry. By the way, I did a reaction to Harry Styles. As far as I am personally concerned as a YouTube creator, whether or not YouTube made a rewind, I really don't think it would have affected them that much negatively. Negatively? They're a massive company, and they have to deal with a lot of different decision-making for the projection of their brand itself. Sure, they want to be careful as a company, as YouTube, as we all know it. It is the only company where you can make a video on your smartphone or whatever kind of camera that you have, post it on the internet, and, well, kind of have a career off of that. So YouTube is important to our culture. In my opinion, for that matter, I really think that if they made a video, it wouldn't be so terrible because it would try and, it would have that approach of uplifting us when we have had all of this mess behind us for 2020. It would be one of those, like, handful of good things that we would have this year. I guess that is me speaking as a creator and thinking if I were to be in YouTube Rewind, or if somebody that I knew were to be in YouTube Rewind, which I know a lot of these creators, or I am aware of them, at least I watch them like you might, so I would want them to be in this video. But since they are not, we might even see a much better Rewind next year. Hopefully Mr. Beast can direct that one. Hopefully a bunch of creators are okay with this and support it, because, well, YouTube needs the creators, the bigger creators at least, that carry most of the views on the channel, on the YouTube platform channel. There's millions of channels, but YouTube as a platform. Could you imagine if all of these top tier creators that have a lot of attention just kind of up and dipped? I don't know. What do you think? I hope you have enjoyed this video, or I've gotten some value out of it. I wonder if you're paying attention to this kind of news. And yeah, I hope you have a good day or night, and I will see you in the next video.